to you by Kellogg's. Kellogg's Cereals. The best to you each morning from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And on my left, the producer of the off-Broadway hit The Ginger Man, Mr. Peter Cook.
And now, young lady who's opening in Mineola on Boxing Day, in Kind Sir, Miss Arlene Francis.
And when is Boxing Day?
December the 26th.
Quite right, too. And now a gentleman who travels a great deal. This time he did it on water skis in Cypress Gardens. He just jetted into us, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Wonderful spot down in Florida, Cypress Gardens. Wonderful skiing, wonderful oranges and grapefruits. And they have a picture down there. Dick Pope, who runs the gardens, has a picture of John Daly down there. He is the only man who fell off of the boat that was pulling the water skis. And there he is, that superb athlete, John Charles Daly.
What Bennett forgot to tell you was he did all of his water skiing in a bathtub. And a small bathtub at that.
You said it.
I must say, it's nice because we have a new neighbor tonight. We've been around so long that it's a rare thing for us to pick up a new neighbor. But on this Sunday night, WHNT in Huntsville, Alabama is joining our What's My Line family. And it's good to have them with us and to have Peter Cook with us. And
thank you very much.
I trust you enjoy the next half hour. We've got some occupations to beguile you, if I may say so. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. We'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now to meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Marion L. Ta. Right? Miss or Mrs. Tarr?
Mrs.
Mrs. Tarr, and where are you from, Mrs. Tarr?
Miami, Florida.
Miami, Florida.
Yes.
That accounts for that wonderful suntan that you have.
Oh, yes.
Mrs. Tarr, may I present our panel? Will you join me over here, please? And I haven't said it in a long time, so I guess I can. You are familiar with our system of keeping score. And there leaves only one thing. That is to let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Tarr is salaried, deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Mrs. Tarr, I just got back from Florida myself a few hours ago, and seemed to me they were very interested in tourists down there. And I wonder if your business, your service, as in any way concerns the millions of tourists that come down to Miami Beach every year.
I think we would have to agree that it's possible that Mrs. Tarr, in the normal pursuit of her labors, might come into some contact with tourists who are coming into Miami, yes.
But does that mean, though, that you could also perform your service for natives and residents of Miami Beach?
Yes.
Is your service performed for adults?
Yes.
Adults of both sexes, Mrs. Tarr?
Yes.
In order to perform your service, do people come to you?
Yes.
Are you located inside of a building rather than in the wide open spaces?
Yes.
Would that building be either a hotel or a motel or an office building?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Tarr, do you by any chance work for a non-profit making organization?
Yes. Well, do you have anything to do with the government? Yes. Is it the government of the state of Florida rather than the United States government? No.
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Cook.
Would I feel physically or mentally better having visited you?
Well, I would say this. With your permission, Mrs. Tarr, I can see circumstances following a visit with Mrs. Tarr which might very well find you in a better mental state than you had been previously.
So that's a yes, is it?
Yes.
I can see conditions, Peter. It's a
qualified. Are you anything to do with income tax?
No.
That's 3.7 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you have anything to do with the marriage ceremony?
No.
4.6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Miss Tarr, do you have anything to do with law or law enforcement?
Yes.
Do you wear your ordinary clothes when you're doing work rather than a uniform?
No.
5.5 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
I'm going to get one yes tonight if it's the last thing I do. Do you wear a uniform, Mrs. Tarr?
Yes.
Why, that's very good.
Great!
Does it have any buttons on it?
Well, I certainly hope so.
Is it blue?
Yes.
Are the buttons brass?
Yes.
Do you have a number connected with your job?
Yes.
Are you in any sense connected with the police department?
No.
No. 6.4 to go, Mr. Cook.
I was just going to ask if you're a warden.
That's all right. Excuse
you can me. Ask that question.
Well,
you
I'm
can.
Not going to. I think
it's
I'd probably.
It's not the police.
It's not the police. It's not the. You're in fact no way connected with the prison.
No.
And when I come to you, you think I don't go
well,
away feeling better.
Could
John
see
thinks
some
I do.
Circumstances, Peter, under which, after the service had been had, you might feel in a better state.
Do you work set hours during the day?
Yes.
And it's a government service?
Mm-hmm, yes, that's been listed.
And is that in any way to do with finances?
No.
No, not except, you know, we'll agree that almost every action between individuals might inevitably wind up with values being ascertained and the value exchanges coming, but not finances directly. Miss Francis?
Law enforcement. You do have something to do with law enforcement.
Yes.
Yes. You're not in an office building. You're not in a jail. Are you in a precinct of any kind? A police precinct?
8.2 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Tarr, are you in a... You're in a government building. Is it a court of any kind?
No.
Not a
9.1 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Tarr, is it possible that you do some of your work out of doors?
No.
10.9 to go. You've never asked the critical question, which government do you work for? Which would have gotten you the federal government and Miami and tourists.
Cape Canaveral?
And how about
Cape
customs
Kennedy.
Inspectress?
By what?
Customs inspector.
Oh, my God.
Dorothy, well, it's surprised. Mrs. Tarr is, I believe, one of six women who are inspectresses at the Miami International Airport.
Oh, they come in now. There aren't many coming from Cuba. I suppose they come from Puerto Rico.
Oh, all of South America.
Yes, Bahamas,
oh, surely.
And things like that.
Yeah, and the southern run coming in up from the Caribbean, all those places. And I think there's something else we should take notice of besides the fact that you are a U.S. Customs Inspectress. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
It's your birthday. Now another challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Joseph S.
And Jack? Peplinski? Peplinski. How do you do, gentlemen? All right. Would you be good enough, Messrs. Peplinski, tell me where you come from?
Chicago.
Chicago? May I present the Peplinskis? And now will you come here and sit down with me? We'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. The Messrs. Peplinski are salaried, and they deal in a service. And we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Messrs. Peplinski, do you always work together in your job?
That's right, we do.
You work for a non-profit-making organization?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Messrs. Peplinski, when you're working, are you visible to the general public?
No.
Two down and eight to go. This is not to say that if you were to go to their place of employment, you would not be able to see them, but they are not on display to the general public, nor do they have as an integral part of their responsibility and their labors to appear before the general public. That's two down, eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Yes.
Well, Mrs. Peplinski, if I were in the proper area and I required your services, could I get them over the telephone?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Cook.
Do both of you do the same job?
Yes, sir.
Could you operate independently?
Yes.
It is perfectly possible that if I came to you, I could see only one of you and get exactly the same service.
Yes,
ma'am. Is it anything to do with the show business in any way?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Is there anything in your job that has security attached to it, protection of some kind?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Is there anything particularly seasonal about your job, Mrs. Peplinski? I mean, would you be dealing in any product that might be particularly used at this Yuletide season?
Yes.
Would it be a product that helps decorate the home?
No.
Six down and four to go. And I want you to carefully review the general scope of the question which Bennett asked, because you can be misled. Miss Kilgallen?
What was his question before I review the scope?
Something that was used in the Yuletide season, which might be, but it was not decorative.
I see. Would you, Mr. and Mr. Peplinski, ever wear a costume other than an ordinary suit?
No.
That makes it seven down and three to go, Mr. Cook.
Is your work manual?
Yes.
Do you deal in any way in machinery?
No.
That makes it eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Do you have anything to do with any livestock of any kind?
No.
Nine down and one to go, Mr. Sir.
Do you play any instrument or anything that has anything to do with a Christmas day, like tolling bells or that sort of
thing? No.
At this time, I would like to say that's all. Ten down and no more to go, and
there's
the brothers Peplinski put laces in footballs. They work for the Wilson Sporting Goods Company, and the surprising thing about it is, I've forgotten which it is. I guess, is it Joe, you've been doing it for 37 years, is it?
37, and you've 38.
And you've been doing it for 38 years. The two of them
sit
there.
What's that got to do with Yuletide, John? They start the season now in July.
I said be careful about the scope of Bennett's question. You know as well as I do, we have Rose Bowl, Cotton Bowl, every kind of bowl game, all at the Yuletide season. They're traditional. Yeah.
And they're Christmas presents.
And their football's a Christmas present.
A lot of people decorate their rooms with footballs.
And trees.
Paint them gaily. Yes.
Better go back to those water skis.
Yes. I would suggest you don't even put any water in the bathtub this time, Bennett. Thank you very much, Mr. Peplinski. And Mr. Peplinski for being our guest on What's My Line. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our sponsor. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which my friends are blindfolded. As usual, are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, John.
Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? Panel, different form of questioning, one at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and let's begin with Dorothy Gilgallon.
Are you in show business?
Yes.
Mr. Cook.
Are you in films?
Yes and no.
Yes what? And no, which is meant to convey that we don't want to mislead you. We will agree that our guest is in films, but we do not mean to suggest that is currently appearing, for instance, on Broadway. Miss Francis?
Well, are you then perhaps better known for your work in the theater?
Yes, no.
That would be yes and no also. We'll give you the benefit of the confusion and make it a yes. I would say that our guest is known widely for activity in both fields. Mr. Cerf?
That yes is something I heard recently on an airplane. Are you sometimes known very affectionately as one of the last of the Red Hot Mamas? Huh? Is it Miss Sophie Tucker?
I'm afraid one thing it didn't do us much good is that everybody knows that you were with our good friend Ed Sullivan tonight, so we knew you were in town, and how delightful of you to come and visit us, too.
Well, it's a pleasure to come here.
It's a joy to have
you. And Daddy, 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 of course,
where'd
Daddy.
You get that hat?
Isn't that a wonderful hat? That's all feathers, isn't it? Real feathers?
Ostrich feathers?
Yeah.
Ellie Jean made it in Madison Avenue chocolate shop.
It's as cute as it can be.
Sing to us, Sophie.
Oh, God. Yeah,
these are all feathers. I wish you had... I wish we had color, because it's a lovely, I guess you'd call it mauve.
It is a mauve.
It's mauve, anything, yes.
It's a mauve.
It's just great. It's a very attractive hat, but then it's on a very attractive lady.
Will you stop all that?
Yes, all right.
Old gal getting around on her. No, all right. This has been a delight, but so short, I thought we'd have a long, long time trying to guess me. That's why I wouldn't speak.
Ah, that voice of yours is very hard to... Very hard.
Yes. Yes.
Remember, you did that all the way down on the plane one day to me, and I got
And you remember it?
Yes, I did.
Which do you remember best, Bennett, the yes or the no?
I never remember the no.
Ah, dear. Wonderful. And Miss Sophie, thank you so much for coming.
Wonderful seeing you, too.
Wonderful to see you.
Thank you.
To admit you recouped your fortunes and some congratulation is in order. We'll have another contestant after this word from our alternate sponsor. And now to meet a final contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Walter J. Buckert, Jr. Right there? Where are you from, sir?
From Palisades Park, New Jersey.
Palisades Park, New Jersey.
Across the river.
Across the river. Right across the river, the Palisades we look at across
right.
The river. Well, these are all your neighbors in part, except Peter's a kind of visiting neighbor. Mr. Buckert, our panel. Will you join me over here, please, sir? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. We can tell you that Mr. Buckert is salaried and deals in a product, and we will begin the general questioning with Peter Cook.
Good evening, Mr. Buckert. Is this a product I would keep in my home? Yes, it is. Would I keep it in any particular room in my home?
Not in any particular room, no. That's one down and nine to go, Miss Friends.
Is it a product that anyone on the panel might use?
Yes.
Is it a product that might be seen on the person?
Not necessarily.
No, I think that if we were to answer that affirmatively, Arlene, I would subsequently be accused of misleading you, and though I can, by stretching points, see a situation and condition under which this might barely be possible, I don't allow the affirmative answer because it might, on the other hand, be something in the other. Mr. Sir.
Mr. Bucket, does that devious answer, Mr. Daly's, mean that this product of yours is actually worn on the person in some way where it is not seen?
Would you give him a good hearty
no?
No, that's fine.
Why,
that's 3 down and 7 to go.
Miss fellow, yo.
Miss Kilgallen.
Mr. Bucket, does the devious answer mean that the product might be something that I could pick up and hold like this for a photograph, and therefore it would seem to be on my person?
Well, I would say, with your permission, to clarify this situation, all I meant to convey was that perhaps it could be said that under certain circumstances the product was in such a contiguous relationship to your person that it might almost be considered as having been worn. But I think you would be well to abandon this particular area of questioning, because I'm confused about it myself now.
I am abandoning ship. Is this product solid rather than liquid, Mr. Buckert?
Yes.
Has it been asked if we could hold it in our hand?
Several times.
If not, I will ask it. Could I hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Could I carry it about?
Yes.
Would it be unseemly if I walked down Fifth Avenue with this in my hands?
I don't think we could say it would be unseemly, no. You certainly couldn't be criticized, necessarily, for walking down Fifth Avenue with this product in our
hand. You mean I wouldn't be considered some kind of a nut?
You mean it wouldn't mean you were some kind of a nut?
Yes, wouldn't seem I was some kind of a nut.
Oh, of course
I'm just trying to get a yes.
I can't think of any circumstance under which anybody would consider you was some kind of a nut.
Oh, I can. You're getting the Christmas spirit early. all right. I could walk around with this solid thing in my hands and nobody would think I was a nut. Is this something that is useful?
Yes.
Is it used by people more than animals?
Yes.
Is it used by grown-ups more than children?
No.
I would say this, with your permission. In balance, I would say that the use is in the control of adults, and to that degree, we might consider that it was used more by adults, or it certainly is much by adults.
Oh, that's correct.
Okay, so you go ahead, darling. Right.
Does it have any moving parts?
No.
No. 4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Cook.
Does this contiguous product in any way help to clean the house?
Oh, dear, why didn't I stay home now? Well, no,
it doesn't
its purpose
the house,
is not
it?
To clean. Yeah. Its purpose is not to clean. Arlene?
Is it something that is put on something else?
Well, I'm glad we're running out of time. I quit, I must say. And I want to be able to see, because you may have some complaints. Actually, I guess, Mr. Bucket, we'd have to agree some of these questions read you, but he makes light bulbs, or rather sells light bulbs, you know, for General Electric. You know, you have flashlights, which sometimes you could have on your person, you hang them on a wrist. And I guess I confused you, and I'm sorry. And I'm sorry, Mr. Bucket,
sure,
I messed things up, too. Nice to have you with
anyway.
Me. Good night, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Good night, John. And the filaments wiggle. Good night, Peter.
Good night, Arlene.
Good night. Good luck with the new edition of Beyond the Fringe,
Thank
Peter,
you.
In January. Good night, Bennett.
Good night, Mr. Daly.
Good night, Mr. Cerf. And thank you all for being with us on What's My Line?
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. Johnny Olson speaking.
And I think there's something else we should take notice of, besides the fact that you are a U.S. Customs Inspectress. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Now another challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Joseph S. And Jack. Peplinski? Peplinski. How do you do, gentlemen? All right. Would you be good enough, Messrs. Peplinski, tell me where you come from?
Chicago.
Chicago? May I present the Peplinskis? And now will you come here and sit down with me? We'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. The Messrs. Peplinski are salaried, and they deal in a service. And we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Messrs. Peplinski, do you always work together in your job?
That's right, we do.
You work for a non-profit making organization?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Peplinski, when you're working, are you visible to the general public?
No.
Two down and eight to go. This is not to say that if you were to go to their place of employment, you would not be able to see them, but they are not on display to the general public, nor do they have as an integral part of their responsibility and their labors to appear before the general public. That's two down, eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, Mrs. Peplinski, if I were in the... Yes? Are you in any sense connected with the police department? No.
No. Six down and four to go, Mr. Cook.
I was just going to ask if you're a warden.
That's all right. Excuse
you can ask that question.
Well, I'm not going to. I think
it's
I probably.
It's not the police.
It's not the police. It's not the. You're in fact no way connected with the prison.
No.
And when I come to you, I could see some
circumstances, Peter, under which, after the service had been had, you might feel in better state.
Do you work set hours during the day?
Yes.
And it's a government service?
Mm-hmm, yes, that's been listed.
And is that in any way to do with finances?
No.
No, not except, you know, we'll agree that almost every action between individuals might inevitably wind up with values being ascertained and the value exchanges coming, but not finances directly. Miss Francis?
Law enforcement. You do have something to do with law enforcement.
Yes.
You're not in an office building. You're not in a jail. Are you in a precinct of any kind? A police precinct?
Eight down and two to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Tarr, you're in a government building. Is it a court of any kind?
No.
Not a court?
Nine down and one to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Tarr, is it possible that you do some of your work out of doors? No.
Ten down and none to go. You've never asked the critical question, which government do you work for? Which would have gotten you the federal government and Miami, and tourists.
Cape Canaveral?
And how about Cape Customs Kennedy. Inspectress?
By what?
Customs Inspectress.
Oh, my God.
Dorothy, well, surprised. Mrs. Tarr is, I believe, one of six women who are inspectresses at the Miami International Airport.
Oh, they come in now. There aren't many coming from Cuba. I suppose they come from Puerto Rico.
Oh, all of South America.
Bahamas,
oh, surely.
And things like that.
Yeah, and also, the southern run coming in up from the Caribbean.
For adults?
Yes.
Adults of both sexes, Mrs. Tarr?
Yes.
In order to perform your service, do people come to you?
Yes.
Are you located inside of a building rather than in the wide open spaces?
Yes.
Would that building be either a hotel or a motel or an office building?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Tarr, do you by any chance work for a non-profit-making organization?
Yes. Well, do you have anything to do with the government? Yes. Is it the government of the state of Florida rather than the United States government? No.
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Cook.
Would I feel physically or mentally better having visited you?
No.
Well, I would say this. With your permission, Mrs. Tarr, I can see circumstances following a visit with Mrs. Tarr, which might very well find you in a better mental state than you had been previously.
So that's a yes, is it? Yes.
I can see conditions, Peter. It's a
call. Are you anything to do with income tax?
No.
That's 3.7 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you have anything to do with the marriage ceremony?
No.
4.6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tarr, do you have anything to do with law or law enforcement?
Yes.
Do you wear your ordinary clothes when you're doing work rather than a uniform?
No.
5.5 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
I'm going to get one yes tonight if it's the last thing I do. Do you wear a uniform, Mrs. Tarr?
Yes.
Why, that's very good.
Great!
Does it have any buttons on it?
Well, I certainly hope so.
Is it blue? Yes. Are the buttons brass? Yes. Do you have a number connected with your job?
What Bennett forgot to tell you was he did all of his water skiing in a bathtub. And a small bathtub at that.
You said it.
I must say, it's nice because we have a new neighbor tonight. We've been around so long that it's a rare thing for us to pick up a new neighbor. But on this Sunday night, WHNT in Huntsville, Alabama, is joining our What's My Line family. And it's good to have them with us and to have Peter Cook with us. And
thank you very much.
I trust you enjoy the next half hour. We've got some occupations to beguile you, if I may say so. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. We'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now to meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Marion L. Tarr, right? Miss or Mrs. Tarr?
Mrs.
Mrs. Tarr, and where yes. are you from, Mrs. Tarr?
Miami, Florida.
Miami, Florida.
Yes.
That accounts for that wonderful suntan that you have.
Oh, yes.
Mrs. Tarr, may I present our panel? Will you join me over here, please? And I haven't said it in a long time, so I guess I can. You are familiar with our system of keeping score. And there leaves only one thing, and that is to let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Tarr is salaried, deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Well, Mrs. Tarr, I just got back from Florida myself a few hours ago, and seemed to me they were very interested in tourists down there. And I wonder if your business, your service, is in any way concerns the millions of tourists that come down to Miami Beach every year.
I think we would have to agree that it's possible that Mrs. Tarr, in the normal pursuit of her labors, might come into some contact with tourists who are coming into Miami, yes.
But does that mean, though, that you could also perform your service for natives and residents of Miami Beach?
Yes.
Is your service performed?
To you by Kellogg's. Kellogg's Cereals. The best to you each morning from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And on my left, the producer of the off-Broadway hit The Ginger Man, Mr. Peter Cook.
And now, young lady who's opening in Mineola on Boxing Day, in Kind Sir, Miss Arlene Francis.
And when is Boxing Day?
December the 26th.
Quite right, yes. Too. And now a gentleman who travels a great deal. This time he did it on water skis in Cypress Gardens. He just jetted into us, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Wonderful spot down in Florida, Cypress Gardens. Wonderful skiing, wonderful oranges and grapefruits. And they have a picture down there. Dick Pope, who runs the gardens, has a picture of John Daly down there. He is the only man who fell off of the boat that was pulling the water skis. And there he is, that superb athlete, John Charles Daly.